The first question is to Mr. Narayan Venkat. What would be the impact on Nifty or Sensex if the interest rates along with the rupee or the dollar and even the gold and crude prices in the international market go down?
I think the question has to go to the exchange.
Right, sir, I'll let you think it then.
Gaurav will, I think.
Okay, so here it is. My answer would be that, does it really matter? I already, and honestly, I don't know the answer, because what you're asking me is to predict, and unfortunately, I'm not an astrologer as of now. But does it, I really don't know the answer, and another part is, does it really matter? Because that's what I spoke about. What are your financial goals? When do you need to achieve? And whether it goes up or comes down, is it going to really make the difference? I really have no idea on this, and I'm ill-equipped, I'm sorry, but this is the way I would have handled it with all my clients or viewers or audience, saying that focus on your goals, don't look at this way, because I can, or all of us on the stage here can give you some number, can give you some prediction, can say that, okay, dollar will go up, dollar will go down, rupee will go up, gold, all those things, but those are predictions, and that's not going to make any difference to your financial goals.
Thank you so much, sir. The next question to Mr. Pritam Chatterjee. How do I select the different fund houses for investment in equity through mutual funds?
Hello?
Look, couple of things we need to take into consideration.
Hello?
So, obviously, return is there. How the fund has fared over a past few years or the investment horizon. But not only return in isolation, you need to consider the risk as well. Many websites are there where you can get ratios like Sharpe ratio and other. It's simple that what is the return output you are getting in comparison to the risk. So risk per, return per unit of risk is important. You need to consider that size of the AUM, the fund manager experience, expense ratio, all these things. And there is structured information available on website these days. So getting information is not challenging. Not only return, but in context with the return, other things also need to be considered.
The next question to Mr. Mashruwala. Would you recommend some books to read or any periodicals or websites that we may follow?
Yeah, lot of them. So our regulators are doing brilliant job. One is a joint initiative by four regulators. There is this institution initiative, which is NCFE, and it's set up by NISM, which is done by RBI, SEBI, IRDA, and PFRDA, National Center for Financial Education. So you can visit their website, and they really have good material there, reading material. They also have a lot of videos, and all the regulators. So there are some videos made by Reserve Bank of India, stuff done by SEBI, Insurance Regulatory Development Authority. So one is keep visiting this NCFE website, number one. Number two, both the exchanges, NSC and BSC, they are doing wonderful job. Apart from that, Reserve Bank of India on their own website, they have a lot of material which is there. They have certain comics, and while these comics, we normally feel they are for kids, a lot of these comics are really, really good comics, and you may want to download and read, because they have explained the concept in very simple and lucid language. A lot of mutual fund companies are creating a lot of material, and it's really worth going through that. Most of them have done it more for investor education, so there is no product selling that's happening there. So you may want to look at that. Apart from that, obviously there is media activity that's happening. So there are TV shows which are there, and there is a lot of things being written in terms of websites. Also, all the names that I mentioned, it's there on the internet. So there's lots and lots of material which is available, and you may want to read all of them. It's really good stuff that we have. I mean, last 4 or 5 years, there's a lot of activity which are happening around creating awareness for investors, these kind of events. You may want to attend those events. All these things will really add a lot of value.
Thank you, sir. The next question is directed towards Mr. K.S. Rao. A friend of mine asked me how mutual funds were safe, and I was left speechless. How do I answer this question on the basis of facts? and the facts are in inverteds.
Okay. I always believe with mutual funds, when you invest, you can have a peace of mind. I'm sure it is, which fund you are investing is a question. If you are coming for a short term, you are coming to your liquid funds, I think you need not worry about it. It's I showed in one of the infographics, there is a stability of capital and there is a capital growth, how you can look at. And can you repeat the question, the last part?
He wanted to be able to answer his friend on the basis of facts.
Facts, I think, it's the best fact I can look at is mutual fund. There are 5 fund houses which have completed 20 years of their inception now. I was just looking at those 4 funds. They have little over 40 or 30, 36 or 40 funds, which are the equity funds which they are managing. On average, in the last 20 years, the kind of growth, CAGR they have given, is little over 17%. That's the biggest fact. It means 20 years of the mutual fund, I'm talking about all the, including private and public sector, but there are 4 fund houses, the 4th fund which celebrated recently the 20th year, combinedly together, they have given over 17% CAGR on their equity funds. That's the kind of alpha which is creating. I think I don't look at it beyond a fact. I think Gaurav wants to add something to it.
So again, to say that there weren't facts, probably the counter question should have been that why did you invest in a particular mutual fund scheme and what was the goal? Because if that was not done, you're bound to have problems. Imagine a situation whereby, since I live in the western part of India, Mumbai, Ahmedabad is what I frequent oftenly, and say if I've taken a train which is a Duranto. So it starts from Mumbai and I want to get down at Baroda and the train goes non-stop to Ahmedabad. Now, either I jump at Vadodara every time and break my legs or go to Ahmedabad, and then I said train is not serving my purpose. I mean, you wanted to go to Baroda, you purchased ticket. It's just that invariably we have situation whereby people end up making investments in schemes which are not aligned to their goals. And then they end up blaming either a fund manager or a fund house or a particular vehicle. It's like there's a complete mismatch. Mr. Rao spoke about it. Depends on where you want to go. It's like between plane and cycle, aeroplane is faster. But if I want to go 1 kilometer away, can I take a flight? I have to look at cycles. So it's like where you wanted to go and which scheme you picked up. So when you answered your friend, your counter question should have been, what is it for which you want to make investment in mutual fund? And based on that, the facts would have been invariably in your favor. It's just that if that was not done, you're bound to a problem. It's also because mutual funds offer so much variety that you need to pick and choose. Now, if you've not picked your options appropriately, you're bound to struggle. But the moment you picked up your options appropriately, facts will be in your favor.
Thank you, sir. The next question to Mr. Chatterjee. What type of mutual funds are highly probable to perform the best in the next 5 years?
Gaurav sir has time and again shared it's our investment direction or for the purpose for which we are investing. So keeping those things in mind, definitely you cannot take a call. It's basically you need to allocate your assets. It's more important asset allocation. I should stick to that view only. But yes, over a period of 5 years, as you could understand, you should have good amount of exposure towards equity. And on that equity exposure, like I've mentioned in my presentations, take exposures on large caps and obviously on index, because there's the safest bets on equity. Risk mitigation is the important thing. And yes, if possible, try to negotiate with your 5-year investment horizon to a bigger one. It helps.
Thank you, sir. The next question to Mr. Venkat. What is an upper and lower circuit? Can I trade on shares which are suspended due to penal or procedural reasons?
I'll answer from exchange. If a stock is suspended for action, you cannot trade. And second part was the circuit. Can you repeat the circuit?
What is an upper and lower circuit?
Means price of a stock cannot go beyond a particular circuit price. Like if you have stocks on which F&O is there are no circuits. Otherwise, on balance stocks, there are a circuit of 20%, 10%, 5%, and 2%. These circuits are there to maintain the the price doesn't go beyond that day. So previous day's closing price plus minus that circuit limit applies to all the stocks.
Thank you so much, sir. The next question to Mr. Mashruwala. Money management becomes an emotional issue. How do I deal with this, especially when it comes to this, comes to dealing with the, with our respective spouse?
Sir, we are not here to address matrimonial planning. But trust, I mean, so moment I spoke about involving entire family is where situation changes. If I look at scriptures, wives have been, I mean, they're goddess Lakshmi, and there are a lot of families where we have solved it that way by telling spouses, you are goddess Lakshmi and you are the one who's going to take care. Man is a hunter, you are a caretaker, and give due importance to her, which she deserves, and that's one way. Second is involve them. And I already spoke about deciding on financial goals jointly, going on financial date, or whatever way you want to call it a spending list, because then they have a say in it. And most importantly, don't get into a situation where you feel that women don't understand. It's just that men also don't understand, women accept, men don't accept. That's yeah. So at least women, please clap for me. All those women in the audience, because I'm taking your side. But you will have to get into a situation number. It has to go step by step. So it's not interest activities, and that's what we do in real life when clients, husband, wife come to our office for quarterly review, one is we insist. And then we give small activities. So you'd start by telling wife who has not been taking interest, saying that, madam, for next 3 months, can you just file all the mutual fund statements that comes to you? Very simple. I said, don't do anything else. That's the first step. And then next quarter, we said, madam, can you please make a list of it? And believe me, after 9 months or something, or 1 year, we actually have a situation whereby she would start saying, ye scheme mein ye statement barabar nahi hai. Slowly go step by step. Empower them. And they will make mistakes. It's not that men don't make mistakes. I mean, it's men who end up investing in Ponzi schemes more than women. I mean, let's face the reality. So it's not that it's one particular gender which is smart and second is not. It's just that allow them to take decisions, encourage them. Tell them that end of the wealth, the day this wealth is for all of us. If I am ill and if our jointly created wealth is to be utilized for my benefit as well, my health insurance, my health condition or whatever, you are the one who's going to do transactions. So if you're not aware, how will it that help? You need to be aware. In fact, a lot many times for husband, wife, we do joint sessions, we do conduct workshops, and we ask few questions to wife saying that, please write down name and telephone number of your insurance agent, stock broker, chartered accountant. And that's when they realize that they don't know. Either they don't know the names, or they know the names, they don't know the numbers, where those numbers are kept. Start doing these small activities, and you will get their interest. Tell them this is the way to worship Goddess Lakshmi. If you put it in that manner, there are more chances that you will get attention and involve them, but make this a family affair. If it's just one person doing and saying, I know, this is the way you do it, it's not going to work.
I would like to, add to what Gauro said, to get into the action plan to involve even from today. Most of the times we tend to postpone. There is a book which is given to you, is called Janoge Tabhi Toh Manoge. In that second half of the book, it is a personal record book is there. Personal finance record, including everything, you know. It's a, probably today we are into the generation of mobile and soft copy. And keep one hard copy, involve, not the small book, the bigger one. It's like, you know, the second full pages, you can have your finance records, probably involve your spouse into that, let her start writing it, then definitely I feel WIFE, wife will become wealth invited forever.
Very well said, sir. I would like you to hold on to the mic. The next question is directed again to you. What is the difference between investing in mutual funds through a broker or agency and buying it directly from a fund house?
There is an option, which is a direct option, which is available. But it's a choice to you. If you know, if you are aware where you want to invest, where you have a command and you can do directly. Or it's advisable to come through an advisor where he can guide you and at least he can hold on to you. It's like, and most of the times if you are investing on your own, your emotions drives it, marks end up and down, you take a call of your own and you end up. I keep suggesting people, like I have a doctor, I have a friend who is a doctor in Netra, Narayana Hrudayalaya. Recently his daughter has to go for heart surgery and he said he was one of the best heart surgeons in that place. He said, I am not going to operate for my child. He has chosen his junior doctor to do it because it's emotional to me. And when your money comes, it's very emotional to you. I feel get one good ethical advisor. It is my advice. It's nothing beyond from my company side or something. But when you're coming directly, yes, you have a direct option. There could be an expense ratio difference of around 70 bips over a period of time over the equity funds. But the advice is much more profound than the 70 bips. Anything you want to add?
Thank you, sir. The next question to Mr. Purushottam Saraf. Action to be taken in case of a fraud. How can SEBI help?
Fraud, if it is relating to stock exchange, if a transaction has happened on stock exchange, then it can be the stock exchange investor grievance redressal and arbitration platform is available to you. Within 4 months of lodging of your claim, the award will be given on the merits of the case.
Thank you, sir. The next question to Mr. Mashruwala. Once our goal is reached, should we redeem our investments even if the market is not doing well?
So once you have reached your goal, can you defer that goal? I mean, I gave examples of son's marriage or daughter. I mean, so here is one more strategy. And that's what you need to always follow. When your financial goal is away, look at debt as an asset class. So you could be doing a recurring deposit or a debt fund or whatever. If you're looking beyond 7 to 9 years, equity as an asset class, for an interim period, look at combination of both. Now this would change based on, you know, if your advisor, it could be 1 or 2 years here or there. Which means now you are, suppose you start saving or investing for a financial goal which is going to occur after 10 years. So you're doing an SIP into an equity-based mutual fund. Perfect. Keep doing it. But if you're doing regular reviews, when that goal will be only 3 years hence, which means you have completed 7 years and now only 3 years are away. For 3 years, you should be in a debt instrument and a debt fund or whatever. Hence, you should have started shifting that money slowly into either a debt fund or a debt instrument. Now, if you did not do that, which means you stayed in equity till end, that's not the right strategy. And then you are bound to get into this kind of problem whereby I have to fulfill my goal, but market is not doing well. Ideal strategy is that the money that you need for your goals in less than two to three years should move into a debt-based instrument or debt fund. So please don't get into this situation again. If you're already in a situation where now you have to fulfill a goal and market is not doing well, see if you have other assets which can be liquidated to achieve that goal. But in future, please be careful.
You want to write something?
In fact, it's what Sarah said, there's a name to it, STP, you can think of.
Yeah,
systematic
yeah.
transfer planning.
So systematically transfer from equity to debt, but it should not have, it's like again the same example that I gave for Mumbai to Baroda and taking a Duronto. I mean, if I wanted to go to Baroda, I should have taken any other train which stops. I took a fast train, non-stop train, and then a goal came and I had to jump. It's not a fault of a train or engine driver. It's just that I did not take an appropriate vehicle or I do not make appropriate changes.
Thank you, sir. We have another question back at you. So I've paid 3 installments of 5-year terms of a ULIP. What's the way forward to get a refund as soon as possible?
So these insurance companies really hate me. You know, it's a matter of time before they start giving supari for me. But if 3 years have passed, I mean, I probably need much more information about this particular scheme, and maybe you can ask me later on, as in not the name of the scheme, but the kind of fund and lock-in period. If you want money back, obviously, after a particular kind of period whereby, you know, your tax benefits and whatever is there, you can just ask for money and it will come back to you. But usually, maximum damage is done in the initial years. So if that damage has already been caused, then take a call as to Now, do you want to stay a little longer or do you have better options? Usually there will be another better option, but if you are already into it, just evaluate the option and then move out at the earliest.
Thank you, sir. The next question to Mr. Chatterjee. What's the difference between a liquid and ultra short term mutual fund?
Look, liquid, as it is said, it is like a contingency fund. So you can expect a return of something, anything 7.5-9% at times occasionally. So these are very liquid instruments. The maturity of those instruments varies for something within less than 91 days of that sort. So hence the name. Now, ultra short term, as you go to the ultra short term category, the maturity of the instruments starts increasing, something close to 1 year above that. So on those lines. But if you have a short term investment horizon, very liquid funds, as Saras meant, keeping aside in your home the contingency fund like the Chennai people might be requiring right now. So this kind of funds you put aside in your home, and after that, whatever surplus you have, you can always park it to the liquid funds. And on those lines, I would also like to request you to consider that there is also liquid Bs. Say, for example, there are 52 weeks. So there are traders. At times, I got subject myself to those traders' experience. So Saturdays and Sundays, if you say 52 weeks, 52 into 2, something on 104, some more holidays are there, it adds up to something around 120 odd days. So approximately one third of the year. So just imagine if you are getting 7% return and it's a corpus like 1 crore and one third of that, something 2% or 2.5%, whatever the case may be on that 1 crore, it's on absolute terms, it's a huge money. Better way of utilizing your ideal funds. It makes a whole lot of sense. So.